Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you, Father, for today. Father, Lord, we thank you, Father, for this week. Father, faith and family, Father, we thank you, Father, for this thanks for giving week. Father, Lord, we thank you, Father, for our treasured friends, Father, in love, our treasured family, Father, in love, Father, in blessing, Father. And Lord, we thank you, Father, for giving us that treasured friend and family, Father, in love and blessing, Father, without no end, Father. Lord, we thank you, Father, that you will bring contentment in them, in their lives, Father. Continue to comfort them in the time of strife, in the time of adversity, Father. Lord, comfort them in the time of their needs, Father. Continue to keep them safe, Father. Lord, let their path, Father, be straight, Father, and Father, Lord, let their path in you, to you, be sure, Father, oh God. Lord, I continue to pray that you will continue to bless them, Father, Lord, continue to meet their needs, Father, Lord, I thank you, Father, for their presence in my life, Father, Lord, I ask you, Father, that you will watch over them, Father, Lord, the family, our friends, Father, Lord, watch over them, Father, and lead them to hope and blessing, Father, Lord, I trust you that you will protect them and hold them dear when life becomes hard, Father, and whenever they need you, God. Lord, I just thank you, Father, to help me, help us be a great friend and a great family member, whether we have the title of son, Father, Lord, whether we have a title of daughter, whether we have a title of mother, title of father, Lord, title of sister, brother, whatever title that we hold, Father, Lord, let us be that good title to them, Father. And Lord, we just ask you, Father, that on this entire week, Father, as we continue on, Father, that we will be that good whatever title to them, Father. We be it good, Father. Lord, we lift your name on high and we glory and magnify your name. Cause it is in you that we live, move, and most certainly, most of all, have our being. Cause it is in your Son Jesus' name. It is in his name that we pray, and we lift your name on high in glory and magnify your name. It is in his name. And Father, Lord, I just thank you, Father, for the Arch 3 show. And Father, as a host, as the executive producer of this show, Father, Lord, I thank you, Father, for my position and my title, Father, and that I am continuing to display that good, whatever title or position that I hold. Father, that good person, Father, and be an example, a great example, Father. And Lord, I just thank you, Father. And because as I continue on praying, Lord, I just thank you, Father, that it is in your Son Jesus' name that I pray. Amen. Y'all, let's get started. It is time for an all new broadcast of the Arch 3 Show. We are in the middle part of the week. Let's go ahead and get it going. Let's get it started. It's time to praise him. Let's go.
The RH3 show is all new.
We got hope, we got faith, and we got family and love. It is our faith and family thanks for giving week on this week, and we are continuing it on today right here on the Arch 3 Show. Join us as we give you all part 3 and explain to you why it is important and why is family time worth it. Alright? Why family time and why dinner time is so worth it. Let's join it on today during our Real Talk with Rufus discussion. Plus, we got some more Inside Scoop with Rufus News. You don't want to miss it. It's a great conversation, a great discussion. Pull up your chair. Let's have a conversation. All right now. It starts today. Let's go.
You get it now. Live from North Carolina, it's the RH3 Show.
I wasn't scared to go over the edge.
Look, I do this for nobody but my co-hosts. Because
God first,
didn't my co-hosts.
I've been doubted, I've been counted out, I've been overlooked. because your listeners are you know, international, they're worldwide.
The RH3 Show starts right now.
I gotta pray because he set me free. Christ said he paid for me at Calvary. I'm gonna dance and there's no stopping me. Don't ever change because I got the victory.
What's going on, good people? How y'all doing on today? Welcome to another great day, another great hour right here on the RH3 Show. Hold on, you all. I gotta zoom my notes in because I don't have my glasses on today. I don't have my glasses on today. Hope y'all are doing good. I'm doing well. Welcome to another great day, another great hour. We're all new. We're all new, and we are here for you all on today. Another great show, another jam-packed show on today. We are in our part three of our faith and family. Thanks for giving lead. Thanksgiving week, and what is that, Rand? What is that, Rufus? We are, you know, we just deemed a faith and family week. We do it, you know, during the month of, I was about to say September, month of November, and sometimes we pull it throughout the year and just celebrate faith and family. Celebrate family, you know, just a time of spending with family and loved ones. The holiday season. Holiday season. Holiday season. Yes, the holiday season. And so on, you know, during this time, it's a season of harvest, season of celebration, season of family, season of love, and, you know, just celebrating family. You know, whether you celebrate Thanksgiving or not, which, you know, me and my family, we don't. But, you know, in spite of and because of, we just celebrate the love of family, the love of food, and just say, God, I thank you. You know, God, I praise you. You know, we lift your name on high in glory and magnify it. And so, you know, hey, while everybody is prepping, and I, you know, a friend of mine, before I go into that, I'm going to give y'all the lineup, the run through on today's show. You know, of course, we got great music. Prayerfully, if, you know, of course, the RH3 Show and some of the stations that the RH3 Show play on is just a music-based, you know, platform, music-based show, music-based station. And some of it is, you know, generated talk. And so this is a talk show that, you know, is just a generated show. We were a show that played music and come on throughout the show and talk. But back in maybe what? I forgot what year we started. We are on our 7 year of radio. And so y'all, my math ain't mathing. So let me calculate. I love saying that. I love saying that. So, we are on our 7 year of radio. So, in 2015, we started radio. And so, I would say about what? 2017, we became full talk. At least full talk. Probably about 90% of talk. And you know, it was a hard transition. And so, at least about 90% of our full-hour show became full talk. And in 2020, we became 5 days a week. And so, you know, that was, you know, a big transition. And so, yeah. But, you know, excuse the stations for, you know, whatever, but, you know, not really excuse because that's just the platform of what we are, but, and then they accepted us by adding and putting us on their platform and, you know, stations by accepting us being, you know, all talking, just 90% of talking, you know, playing music, so throughout the show, if we get time to play music, we just get time to play music. But we, if we do, we're going to play some Brian Courtney Wilson. We may do some of you know, some Winer's Wine. And I think his wife is Lisa. I think his name is Wine. And Lisa Winans. And we probably have, who is, I'm about to say Joker. Brian Courtney Wilson. I think I said him, but a few more. But anyway, we got him, and then we also have our Real Talk with Rufus. I'm gonna go in depth, inside scoop back with Chris Brown, Ty Chris Lee. I'm gonna go in depth with Jason Weaver. Some that we skimmed over at the end of the show on yesterday. And then, of course, we got our Real Talk with Rufus discussion about the faith and family Thanksgiving part 3. Why family time, why dinner time is important. And, you know, we have to make it a norm and bring it back. And, you know, whether we have it at the dinner table, whether we have it in the living room, whether we have it in the family room, whatever. Why is it important? And, you know, whatever, and, you know, God has just been dealing with me even about that and, you know, whatever. And so, I don't like plate drop-offs. I don't. And we're just going to have to, because January, I'm cutting off because I don't like snootiness in people. You know, of course you got your, you know, your own family, but don't be funny vibes. I don't. But anyway, yesterday Apostle Jamila spoke on being unstable during the Car Chronicles movement devotional. And so, yeah, I gotta, you know, keep it moving. But anyway, yeah. And so, we got the inside scoop with Rufus News. But after this break, we got Real Talk with Rufus discussion, and we're gonna jump on that. But this break is a music break. But here's Brian Courtney Wilson with Hope. I'm gonna make it if I just have hope. All right. Here's Brian Courtney Wilson with Hope Saved My Life, y'all. Hope saved my life and, oh, Jesus, hope saved my life and, Lord, have mercy. Hope saved my life and the Holy Spirit and being saved me out of prison. Lord, have mercy. Because right, you know, I was about to say right now I'd be booked, being booked in process. But no, I'd probably be, you know, either right now, this week, I probably would be sending letters through electronic email or pen pal or whatever. But, you know, hope saved my life, and hope, you know, kept me from, you know, being out of prison. Listen, you're gonna make it if you just have hope. I be back with more of the Arts 3 Show. I of the Arts. Be back with more. I talk to you in a minute.
The RH3 Show. For more about the broadcast and info on how to listen or watch from where you are, please visit therh3show.com.
It's looking better and I'm loving the weather. Things are coming together.
The best day of my life. people saying things are changing. I'll keep believing, hoping, soul learning. I'll keep on praying.
Yeah,
things are changing. By faith I'll see it. Hope is all I need.
I'll keep on saying, things are changing. Ooh, no, no, no. I'll keep believing. Hope is all I'll keep need. On. I'll keep on praying.
Things are changing.
Things are changing.
Real life, we show real love, and we also have real, non-judgmental conversations, all from a Christian male perspective. Not all of them, just mine. So let's have an open-minded conversation. It's the Real Talk with Rufus, right here on the RH3 Show.
Alright, you fellow people, we are here for our Real Talk with Rufus discussion, and, oh, y'all, my bracelet was about to fall. Anyway, we're here for our Real Talk with Rufus discussion, and we're talking about why I don't know why I'm talking to you all like that. A new way to refer. No, y'all. Okay. Anyway, we're here and we're talking about why is it, not why, well, why family time? Why family time is worth it? Why dinner time is important? And so not only, well, let me put it like this, of course, not only, you know, we want to make it a norm to, you know, spend time with your family throughout the week. And, of course, we all got busy schedules, but we, other cultures, other nationalities, other races, whatever you put it out there, take time out for family, take time out, whatever. But, of course, we all have busy schedules or whatever. If you live in the same household, even if you don't, the main household, whether you mama, daddy, mother, stepfather, father, stepmother, godmother, however your family structure is, and, you know, either you living with them or you don't, you live by yourself, and you have your own family, Make time to come together as one day out of the week, And then, you know, you do your thing as your own household unit. Because like I always say, the regulars hear me say this. Don't let your family ruin your family or whatever. But then, you know, make it a norm to keep peace however you see fit. But also, make it a norm to all come together as one, you and your siblings, their children, you know, mother, however your household structure is, whoever raised you, whatever, and you got peace, trying to bring peace or whatever, come together on that day to have family time, you know, whatever, and do things or whatever. Even, you know, in your own household. And I'm even speaking with the matriarch, patriarch, whatever, y'all together. Like with me and my household. And it's just me in the home by myself and whoever comes and whoever stays. Look, on Mondays, you know, it's a free fall. Tuesdays, whatever it is, you know, no matter, you know, how it is, whether I order out, whether I make it myself because I love to cook, or whatever, I have Taco Tuesdays. That's it. And now I'm at the point to, I'm about 75 to 80%. And when I say 75 to 80%, I don't have, when I do eat, I'm trying to eat way more. But when I do eat, I do eat it. That's the meat I eat. But when I don't eat, I don't eat. I need to start eating a whole lot more. But whenever I do eat, that's what I eat. But whenever I don't eat, I just don't eat, period. But whenever I do eat a meat, that's what I eat. I eat fish. Well, get to the point, Red, because I just realized I'm just talking. But I'm about 75 to 80%, you know, eating just pescatarian and meat or what. I mean, you know, fish. But on Tuesdays, I'm trying, and I have, and whenever I do talk, when the last time I did Taco Tuesdays, I haven't, you know, incorporated the fish part in that yet. And I have to research, and because, y'all, this is all new, this is all Greek to me, and it's all new to me. Well, not really the pescatarian diet part, but incorporating that fish part into the Taco Tuesdays part, because I know you can do fish tacos, I know all of that part, but, you know, whatever. I'm just trying to think, how can I incorporate that into, you know, be more creative outside the fish tacos or whatever. But meal-wise, on Tuesdays, I do Taco Tuesdays. Wednesdays, you know, I cook a meal, regular, you know, whatever. Thursdays, usually, if I don't do Taco Tuesdays, I do it on Thursdays, being as, you know, Taco Tuesday or Thursday. Or I do leftovers from Wednesday's dinner. Fridays, I before I changed my diet, I would do pizzas on Friday, whether it be frozen pizza or, you know, takeout or order in from DoorDash or what have you. Saturdays, I go out if my friends or whatever, or, you know, whatever. And on Sundays, I cook dinner, of course, because Sundays to me and, you know, what I grew up with and, you know, family or whatever, and Southern hospitality from my grandmother, that is deemed as, you know, family time. And, of course, after church, you cook a Sunday dinner, or, you know, Saturday you prep, or even Saturday you cook it. And, or, you know, get up Sunday morning and you prep or cook, and then, or you put in a crock pot or whatever. And then by the time you get out of church, dinner's done, or about 85 to 90% of your dinner done. And then when you get out of, you know, church, you cook your sides and, you know, this, that, and the third, and your dinner's done. And whoever come over, of course you cook enough for the people who comes to dinner. Voila. And that's it. And so that there is a notice to where, you know, that's just a lineup of your, you know, the meal plans. And that is, you know, your, you know, whoever, you know, whatever. And it just, it's an invitation, and it is, you know, what I'm trying to say is, everybody who plays a part in your house, it gives them, like, it should give them either a boost or excite them to play a part in dinner time or play a part in wanting to have fun or eat together as a family, you know? So start incorporating, you know, all of that into your meal plan. And especially on, thank you, Lord, especially on Saturdays. Saturdays is, you know, of course, is deemed as, you know, a relaxing time if you do not, you know, go to church on Saturdays. Because some people use it as a Sabbath or, you know, day to go out to worship, you know, of course, Sunday through Saturday. And then they spend that Saturday as the time of worship. And then some people, you know, use Saturday, get up early in the morning, clean, and, you know, do whatever for Saturday. And, you know, they, you know, go out, either they go shopping or do whatever they need to do in, you know, relaxing day, or go out to the movies, and then they go out. And so, or they bring takeout, you know, to go get takeout. And they bring it in the house. And they just enjoy family time after a good movie. And then they come home after a good nap or whatever. And just enjoy family. And so, you know, whatever. And then, and also, when you see throughout the week, you have to even also monitor emotions and monitor attitudes and a monitor or whatever in your family so they won't interrupt those family times or interrupt the time that y'all spending together. Or, okay, we got something planned for Saturday, but I see, you know, Daquan's attitude, or Daquan is, you know, he got a stank attitude. Oh, we gonna work on this because, nah. You know, come here, Keyshawn. You better go talk to your brother because, and do what you need to do because I'm not gonna have this on Saturday. We got something planned on Saturday, and he's not gonna come in here with that stank attitude come Saturday. Because if he do, all of it is going to get shut down. You know, whatever. And that's how, you know, you bring oneness in your household. Everybody working together to help everybody out to bring, you know, happiness to the dinner table. Happiness to your family or whatever. And so, you know, that's why family time is worth it. You have to. And then being that it is the fall, you know, it is very busy for everybody, you know, because it's all coming together. And a lot is seriously, you know, but it shouldn't be a time to worry. But fall is busy for everybody. Money is spent, you know, October. Money is spent November. Money is spent December. And all of that. And, you know, people shouldn't worry, but do not feel the pressure of it all. If you need assistance for all of that, you know, go get it. Go to a pantry and get food that you need or whatever. And then be grateful that you have. And that's what I said. You know, be grateful that you are able to go to a pantry to get food. And have a cold refrigerator, deep freezer, a ice box, run around town in an ice box with nowhere to go. You know, that was a quote from a movie. But be grateful that, you know, you're able to, you know, go to, you know, whatever. That's if you need those pantries. That's if you need those food giveaways. And, you know, if not, then don't go. But there are people who need those that, you know, able to go and get food for the holidays or what have you. And if you are, if you need, you know, governmental assistance for a period of time, go get it. You know, because these months are back to back to back that, you know, you need to spend money on. You know, of course, that's if you participate in it. Need money for, you know, October for, you know, if you celebrate Halloween or Hallelujah celebration or trunk or treat or whatever, to buy candy, you know, festival items and food and snacks and all of that. Then here comes, you know, November for Thanksgiving meal or whatever. And, of course, don't be depressed. Don't be, well, that too. Don't be depressed for not having money to buy your Thanksgiving Day meal. And but, you know, there should be agents and, you know, organizations to be out there to, you know, help people out. Go and get those, you know, whatever. And again, if you are able to, you know, buy your food, and if you get assistance, you know, go and you know, use your card proudly and say, look, you know, and pray to God that, look, you know, times may be hard and food prices may be going up, but I'm on this system and I'm on, you know, whatever for the time being. And, you know, go get your food, you know, whatever. And same thing for December for Christmas. And even with that, don't be upset that you can't get your children, you know, nothing. And the same thing with Christmas dinner. It might not be as big as Thanksgiving dinner, but what have you. And so it may be busy time for family, schools in full swing, and harvest time or whatever. And, you know, whatever, and activities going on, and you buying costumes, this and that, and your children want this, but, you know, what have you. And I know a lot of people say that, you know, we may not have, you know, whatever. And I get it, because I've seen it. And so, you know, we were blessed to be in a generation to where I was old enough to see my great-grandfather and, you know, whatever, and understand that, you know, hear stories about, you know, how, you know, he raised his children and grandchildren and whatever, and, you know that to where, of course, you may not have a lot of money, but, you know, you have food on your table and clothes on your back and this, that, and the third. But being that this is a season to where you have to be grateful for what you have, and family dinners allows you to keep, you know, be grateful for that. And even if you don't get a toy or whatever for Christmas, be grateful for, you know, the family time that you are able to sit down in a house with a kerosene heater or whatever, and be grateful for that family time. You know, when your mother cook or whatever, grandmother cook, be grateful for they're in that kitchen cooking. You know, because people don't have that or whatever. You know, be, whether it's nutritional or not, just say your prayer that God will take out all impurities or whatever. But I thank you for this food that, you know, we're receiving. You know, whoever gave it to you, whether you went out and bought it from money that you earned or went out and got it from, you know, places that provide it to you. And, you know, thank God that family dinners can bring in and, you know, provide as a time of discussion to where it brings unity in your family, you know. Even if the dinner, you know, is a alternative for takeout, use it as a eating together and watch movies, Netflix, and chill with your family. But how do we get our families together? Start today. Start whenever, you know. Just do it. Just do it. And like I said, have everybody take part in it. And I'm going to say this and then close out this segment. But I shout my son's mother out because, you know, she have, her other three boys at her house. And, you know, she has a niece staying with her. And the other three boys, of course, they're not really of age. She got two of them of age. And then she got one that's in, I believe he's in the 9th grade. But, and then she has her niece. But everybody is take part in throughout the week. Okay, since you are of age and then she got boys. And you know what? Since y'all are of a working age and you know, I'm the only... You know, well, of course, like I said, she got her niece there, but, and then her boyfriend is there at, you know, from the time in or whatever. We all gonna take part of doing some stuff around here. You know, we all gonna take a part of doing it. And so either every day or every other day, so food won't get wasted. Y'all some healthy dudes, you know, they're slim dudes, but y'all are some healthy able-bodied, you know, young adults. Y'all gonna take part in you know, cooking meals. And so, each and every day, those three boys, you know, well, let me say this, you know, they of a size and age, but they take part in their days of, you know, cooking dinner. And so, with her being the head of the household, she assign, you know, she don't really assign, but I think they, amongst themselves figure out, you know, which day they gonna do and, you know, plan accordingly. And so that's that. And, you know, what have you. And of course she work and, you know, take care of whatever and, you know, majority of the duties and the bills and the whatever, and they have responsibility. And, you know, they cool with that because, look, I have, and they're proud, and honestly, they don't argue with that because they, you know, they say, look, we grown, we got to do what we got to do, and we here to help, and we here to, you know, take care of our responsibility, you know, in this house. And so, boom, that's that. And that's all right. And that is all right. And that's how, you know, whatever, because that teaches them responsibility. And whenever they get, you know, out on their own, you know, they are able to do that with their family. And that's why, again, family time and dinner time is important, not only in your house, it also teaches them, you know, whenever your children get older, they do the same thing with their family. And, you know, it all, you know, is a building block to where your family is unified. And that's where they say, you know, of course, you know, generational curses stops here. And, you know, we building on together. And so, that's that. Alright, we'll continue on. We got more of the Arts 3 Show is coming up next. Alright, be back with more.
The Inside Scoop with Rufus is coming up next. Right here on the Arts 3 Show.
It belongs to me. Salvation belongs to me. And I have everything to make salvation complete. 'Cause I know the work is already done. By the power of His blood, I know it's mine. It belongs to me. It belongs to me. Healing belongs to me. And I
makes my healing complete. It doesn't matter how I feel. When his stripes say I am healed, I know it's mine.
Everything you love about The Arch 3 Show is now on our website, thearch3show.com. Adore You Fashion Fix, the Scripture of the Week, Cooking with Soul Recipes, Just for the Family, A Plan of Salvation and Rededication, Sponsorship Information, Shop Arch 3, and a whole lot more just for you. See it first, see it now, only at thearch3show.com. Got to catch up on the news regarding politics, or if you want to know news about the TV, movies, sports, and or the music industry, be it if it's in gospel or any other entertainment genre, well, it is time for the Inside Scoop of the Rufus, right here on the RH3 Show.
All right, you all, we're going to, we're in our Inside Scoop with Rufus news segment, and we're going to combine our kitchen table talk and our Inside Scoop with Rufus news segment end this one segment. So, of course, at the end of this segment, we're going to close out today's show with this segment. And so, let's go ahead and get started. Of course, we got, like I said, a few news, and we're going to clarify, not really clarify, but give you, you know, further in-depth on the ones that we closed out on yesterday. But let's go ahead. Chris Brown sent social media into a frenzy, storm, whatever, on the other day. But he shared a video. You know, he paid a tribute to Michael Jackson on the 40th anniversary of the album Thriller. And so, in the caption, he claimed that he was, you know, they canceled the performance for unknown reasons. And so, you know, but the founder of news, you know, I think it's a news website or whatever, Matthew Bellany, I think it's Bellany, Bellany, B-E-L-L-O-N-I, says that he knows the reason why, and he's the one who is somewhat behind the decision. And that right there was very sad. And so Chris and the award show's producer has been working on the tribute for weeks. And so the producer wanted Chris to perform the awards. Now listen to this. Chris to perform the awards and even perform at the awards to give him the opportunity to showcase his talents after Chris felt, you know, he had been shadow banned from Hollywood since the Me Too movement. And so Bellany claims that when he caught wind of Chris Brown's performance, he immediately contacted the higher-ups at Disney and ABC about the optics of the performance. He says that the prospects of a convicted domestic abuser being an alleged CM, if you understand what I'm saying, on a Disney network wasn't the best idea. The higher-ups didn't even know about Chris' performance until Bellany called and told them. Once executives found out about the performance, they immediately told the producers to cut the tribute as a whole. The producers were reportedly furious at the decision to axe the performance because they knew the backlash they would receive. But after calls with multiple executives through the company, they decided that Chris could still perform, but he couldn't do the tribute because it would be too radioactive. They tried to come up with an alternative plan, but Chris said it's all or nothing for him. Either he does the performance he planned on doing, or he won't perform at all. So he didn't perform and posted the rehearsal footage on his Instagram. And that's what I would have done. So in conclusion, the network canceled Chris MJ performance because they didn't want the blow of two problematic artists being mentioned on their network. Excuse me. It's almost 7 o'clock and I'm going to get me something to eat after this. But that's really sad and emotional and heartbreaking. It really is. Being mentioned on their network at the same time, all this came to fruition because Matthew run his mouth Bellany, who made the initial call to ABC executives about the performance. And it's all according to the Neighborhood Talk. This is sad. This is very sad. This is sad. I hate it for this young dude. I hate it because, you know, he's, for one, he's tried, and he's trying, for one. And for two, you know, I mean, it's, you know, even with broadcasting, you know, campaigns of Mr. Trump on ABC, a whole lot of stuff being broadcasted on ABC, a lot of other stuff, you know. Not only that, music of other songs being played or displayed on ABC. I know y'all even trying to save money, and I know how business work. Even, you know, connecting that with Operation and, you know, however, you know, tying that into Jason Weaver's story that I said on, you know, whatever, and how he turned down $2 million offer for The Lion King because his mama knew he would make more money in royalties. All of that is sad. But I'd have backed out too, Chris. And what you did, posting that thing, you know what? Honestly, two black major stars, MJ and Chris Brown, I wouldn't perform on it either. I would even, all stars of the same, you know, community, I would stay my tail at home or whatever. Boycott. Please believe me. Yes, I would. Moving on. Again, with Jason Weaver, you know, I'm going to read the whole article. It says, Jason, and I just read that top part, but Jason Weaver said his mother saved him from making the biggest mistake of his career when he was cast for the original Lion King. During an interview with Vlad TV, Jason said Disney offered him, the same company offered him a $2 million check up front for being the singing voice of young Simba. At this time, this was the largest check Weaver had received. Weaver was overjoyed, but his mother was hesitant. And so, mind you, this was around the time Disney was, you know, rolling in. They had the movie Blank Check, and they had the other cartoon movies, Aladdin, and all of those other great Disney movies or what have you. And then Jason said that amount of money to an average middle-class black, he didn't say black, but family in Chicago in the early, you know, 90s. I mean, that's something. But immediately my mom goes, now, wait a minute. He told Vlad TV that his mother wasn't satisfied with the idea of him, you know, being paid one flat rate after considering the revenue that Disney would likely make over time today. Imagine Lion, Animal Kingdom. All of the Animal Kingdom come from Lion King and all of the other movies and The Jungle Book and, you know, talk shows and ABC, that's a Disney company, and Aladdin, and Disney World, and you know, Disneyland, and all of that. But she also recalled Disney re-releasing their other animated films. She was also able to see the playing field and go, wait a minute, this is going to make a lot of money over time. So what happens when my son turns 40? Is he still going to be able to get a check from when they eventually re-release this? And he wasn't. So Weaver, who was in his teenage years at the time, he wasn't a child again. So my apologies for that. But opted for the royalties instead. And so his first check was far less than Disney initially offered, $2 million. He recalls making close to $100,000 up front with his first check combined with shared royalties. Over time, Weaver made far more than Disney original offered, and it wouldn't be possible without his mother made sure that I give my mother her just due props and credit for that, because if she hadn't done that, that would have been one of the biggest mistakes of my career and my career business-wise. Explain. He would have had that $2 million check and, you know, probably sitting on a corner straight slanging rocks now or something. No, that came from a rap song, but yeah. Going to the Chrisleys. Todd and Julie Chrisley has finally been sentenced after found guilty in their bank fraud and tax evasion case, and they're just doing big time. Eleanor Ross, a district judge in Atlanta, handed down a stern sentence on Monday to the two Chrisley Knows Best stars. Prosecutors apparently fought for Todd to receive up to 22 years and Julie to receive up to 13, and their own lawyers believe the sentence were too lengthy and attempted to get Todd 9 years and no hard time for Julie at all. The judge still let her gavels sing and hit Todd with 12 years and Julie with 7. They also threw in additional 16 months of probation for each. Prosecutors had quite a bit to say about the two in the sentencing memorandum as well. You hear the music going, the seriousness of the Chrisleys' crimes cannot be understated. And after they defrauded community banks out of tens of millions of dollars, they hid millions of dollars from the IRS, all while going on television to boast about how much they spent on designer clothes. And when they learned that they were under investigation for those crimes, they involved their own family members and friends to obstruct justice. So, hey, you know what? Ooh, so sad. I feel sorry for them, you know. Hey, that's that. I love you all for real, and we got some more great show coming up for you on tomorrow. Y'all join us for part 4. All right, we gonna continue it. We gonna roll on. It's our faith and family week. We'll talk to y'all on tomorrow. See you all. TheArtStreetShow.com for more. I look, also, by the way, listen, we're rolling. We're talking about great YouTube cooks and some more things. But if you want to get a sneak peek of what we're discussing, join us on our podcast platforms tonight. To get y'all a heads up and prepare for tomorrow. But we're gonna discuss it on air too. Peace.
Peace, party people. See you later.
Cause I'm saying bye-bye.
Good night.